Inserting text in PowerPoint is a little different than in some of the other Microsoft applications. You can't insert text everywhere on the slide. You can only insert text into placeholders or text boxes. We've already inserted text into several placeholders. To do this, just click in a placeholder and the insertion point will appear. Then, you can begin typing. To delete text, one letter at a time, just click to place your cursor next to the text you wish to delete. Press the backspace key on your keyboard to delete text to the left of the cursor. Or press the delete key on your keyboard to delete text to the right of the cursor. If you want to delete more than one letter at a time or format your text in various ways, you'll need to know how to select text. I decided I don't want a few of these words on the slide, so I'll just delete them. To select the text, place the insertion point next to the text you wish to select. Click and hold down the mouse button, and while holding it down, drag your mouse over the text to select it. And now release the mouse button. You can see that a highlighted box has appeared over the words. This lets us know which text is selected. Okay, now I'll just press the delete key on my keyboard and the selected text is deleted. Once you've inserted text, you'll need to know how to format it. If you look in the fonts group on the home tab, you can see the font style and size drop-down menus. When I place my cursor inside my title placeholder, I can see that the default font is Calibri and the default size for one line of text is 44. If I click in the subtitle placeholder, I can see the default font size is 32. The subtitle text is also gray by default. You can change these settings to make your text look the way you want it to. Just select the text you want to modify. We'll select our title. A hover menu will appear with some basic formatting commands. Right now, I'll show you how to use these commands from the ribbon, but when you feel comfortable with PowerPoint, you'll find that the hover toolbar will save you some time. To change the font size and make it bigger or smaller, click the drop-down arrow next to the font size box in the fonts group on the Home tab. As you move your cursor over the various font sizes, a live preview of the font size will appear in the document. I love the live preview feature because it lets you see how the font size will actually look in your presentation. Click the font size you want and it will change in the document. Okay. That looks really good, but I'd like to try a different font style. I'll just select the text and click the drop-down arrow next to the font style box on the Home tab. Just move your cursor over the various font styles. Now just click the font style you want, and it will be changed in the presentation. I think I'll do the same thing with my subtitle and change the font to something different. Here, I like this one. There are many other commands in the font group that you can use to format your text in various ways. You can change the font's color the same way you did the size and style. Just click the command and select one of the color options, or select more colors at the bottom of the list to access the colors dialog box. Choose the color that you want and click OK. There are several other options in this font group that I want to show you. Some of them you may use often, while others you will use less frequently. You can format the text using the bold, italic, and underline commands. To use these commands, just select the text you want to modify and click the command. To remove the formatting, you can just click the command again. We can see how each one works. I think underline may work. Yeah, it looks pretty good. The strike through command makes a line through the text, and I don't use it very often. But the text shadow command adds a little drop shadow that's really nice. The clear formatting command undoes your recent formatting changes. The change case commands let you try different case options without having to retype. For example, if I want my title to be uppercase, I can select the command and a list will appear. Then select uppercase from the list. I actually think this option will look good.